All right, guys, we're back with some more Meatloaf. We're checking out the song Bat Out of Hell. Let's get into it.
There's a man in the shadows with a gun in his eye and a blade shining no so bright. There's evil in the air and there's thunder in the sky and a killer's on the bloodshot streets. On down in the tunnel with a deadly horizon, oh, I swear I saw a young boy down in the gutter. He was stopping the foam and the heat. Oh, baby, you're the only thing in this whole world that's pure and good and right. And wherever you are and wherever you go, there's always gonna be some light. But I gotta get out, I gotta break it out now before the final crack of dawn. So we gotta make the most of our one night together. When it's over, you know we'll both be so alone.
This so far.
He's so charismatic.
Right? I was literally thinking the same thing. I was thinking his voice has so much charisma in it.
Yeah, yeah. I was like, he reminds me of Freddie Mercury, like not actually, but like in how much of a performer he is.
Okay, so you're talking about his performance.
Yeah, his voice, his performance.
I was talking about the voice, like the, I don't know, the tune, melody. I don't know these words, you know what I'm saying? But like the way he's delivering the...
Right?
The vocals is captivating.
Right? He's so passionate. He's so focused.
He's switching it up and stuff, you know?
Whenever he does that, I was like, whoa, you know, he's so into this.
Dancing through the night with you. Well, if I gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned. Gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned. Gotta be damned, you know I wanna be damned. There's always gonna be some light. But I gotta get out, I gotta break it out now before the final crack of dawn. So we gotta make the most of our one night together. When it's over, you know we'll both be so alone.
Oh,
sinner before the gates of heaven. I'll come crawling on back to you.
Pause it. He tried to stop you.
Man.
Now,
okay.
I know Meatloaf is not one of your favorite artists.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But has it grown on you at all? Because it started like that with Guns N' Roses.
That's true.
You were not that high on Guns N' Roses when we first started listening to them, but then they grew on you.
That's
true. So I'm wondering, has Meatloaf grown on you
at all? So it's complex, you see, because, I mean, I think Meatloaf is super talented. It's like I can appreciate Meatloaf a lot.
Don't disappoint me here. Don't disappoint me.
I can appreciate his talent. I can appreciate his stage appeal, his, you know what I mean? The song quality. I mean, I actually feel like he puts a lot into the videos and everything like that.
Okay.
You know what I mean? So, I mean, I have nothing negative to say. It's just like, then there's other artists where it's like, wow, they did something that like was a bonus to me. That made me like, you know what I'm saying? Something that like, you know what I'm saying? It's like something got to get you up out of your seat clapping. Now, if I was at a concert, though, that'd be different. Because I get the impression it was very powerful in person.
Right.
You know what I mean? So we're also dealing with like, older audio video quality.
Okay.
And you know what I'm saying? Like,
yes.
So.
I make my stay. But I can't stop thinking of you. And I never see the sun on curve till it's way too late. Song. Torn and twisted at the foot of a burning bar. And I think somebody somewhere must be tolling a bell. And the last thing I see is my heart still beating. I'm breaking out of my body and flying away like a bat.
Wow. I wonder where he got his name from, Meatloaf. You know what I mean?
Probably favorite food or something. Or maybe there was an incident that happened with meatloaf, you know?
Yeah. Meatloaf is like a very peculiar meat.
It was like a nickname from childhood.
Yeah.
Like everyone I grew up with, not everyone, but some people just had weird nicknames like that. I don't know. Some,
isn't
some
a
things
meatloaf
just
basically
stick.
Just hamburger with meatloaf seasoning? You know what I mean?
I don't know. I think it's ground beef, I think.
Right? Don't you make it with ground beef, but you put a lot of stuff in it?
I've never made
it
one.
It tastes like meatloaf.
I've had some.
So you
need
peculiar
one.
Meat. Interesting. Yeah, what an interesting artist. I feel like he reminds me of like Broadway.
Really?
Like sort of though. I wouldn't say just Broadway because he's not, the voice isn't quite like operatic and theatrical. You know
right.
what I mean? It's somewhere in between like a rock voice and a theater voice.
It is very interesting because like his music, okay, let's take this song. There was a lot of, what do you call it, switch-ups, progressions?
Yeah,
I don't know what you call them. Yeah. There's a lot of those. I don't like those in general, but I like it in his,
yeah,
in his
like
songs,
it,
I like
yeah.
it. And like when Queen does it, I like it. Certain yeah. bands, certain artists can do it, and it's like, it goes. It kind of moves your emotions up and down with it. And then yeah. when other artists do it, it just like rubs me the wrong way. It's just like so abrupt. It's just like, really? Why'd you have to switch it up? You were doing good. You know what I mean? But
yeah.
I like it when
yeah.
Meatloaf does it.
There's it's so interesting, you know, like the angle different artists take with their music. Because sometimes I feel like they're trying to take you on this emotional journey. And other times I feel like it's sort of a production and a performance and stuff that's supposed to take you on a journey, you know. So I don't know. Yeah, it's wild.
I don't know. I feel like Meatloaf does both. It definitely moves me emotionally. Probably not the way the song was intended to. I don't know, but I feel something. A lot of songs I feel nothing.
Yeah, true. True.
A lot of songs I feel nothing. So it's like, I like Meatloaf. I don't know why. I like when I listen to the music the way I feel. Pretty
right,
much.
He's so unique.
His upbeat, happy
yeah.
sound.
He's one of a kind.
And his voice is crazy. I don't know what he does with his voice.
Yeah.
I need to look this up. I need to stop saying
you
I don't
know what else?
It means.
You know what
I
else?
I think it's the pitch or the tune or the tone. I don't yeah. know. Like, I think it's charismatic how he uses his voice.
I can't put my finger on him. But you know what else I think it is?
What?
So like the bands I like most from like the 70s, like Led Zeppelin, like Skinner, Pink Floyd, okay, like older, like they sound to me old. So like modern day or back then, to me it just sounded like dated music, you know, and I like that about it. But to me, Meatloaf doesn't exactly sound like old music.
Yeah, it doesn't.
And I think, like I think he was ahead of his time actually. So I think that's also part of why I can't put my finger on it. You know what I mean? Like, yep. I like stuff to sound very old, you know?
Like, which decade is this from?
Right, this is technically from the 70s, but it doesn't sound
oh,
like
okay.
it.
Oh, okay, yeah.
Same era as Led Zeppelin and stuff. Doesn't sound like it to me.
Oh, yeah, you looked it up before you said it in the
yeah.
stream, huh?
Yeah.
Because yeah. I was like, I don't know which decade it's from. It probably says it in the stream.
Yeah, I think this one was 77. But, like, Black Sabbath, like, a lot of stuff sounds old, and I really... Like, to me, it's like, I can put my finger on it, it's comfortable, you know?
Right.
So, I don't know.
I don't know. Tell me, man, what do you know?
What do you know?
Me and my boys on the road. You the go. She told me, boy, you the go. Like, I don't know. But I don't know.